guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Reading Bear, and I hope you are ready for some more stories. And today, we'll take a look at some new I Don't Work Here Lady content. If you enjoyed my content, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and post some bear emojis in the comment. And now, let's dive right into the stories.
The first one is titled, Story 1. Today, it's just me and the Karen. I'm at Asda, picking up some milk, sugar, a nice loaf of tiger bread and a few other things, when I hear the sound of approaching feet and the familiar harumph of the local Karen. She raises her hand, index finger extended, and opens her mouth in a way that suggests she's going to tell me what to do, and call the manager all in one, when she pauses, having looked me in the eye. Her hand is halfway to its intended destination, and her mouth is open. Paused. I smile, and say, "You asked nicely. I respect that. Well, I showed her to the freezers, and she got the pizza she wanted. Then she said thank you. It felt nice today. Wholesome." The next one is titled, How Not to Recruit a Nurse. In nursing school, you have clinical days. The day before clinical you have to go to the hospital and pick a patient you'll work with the next day. You also have a chance to work as a CNA while in school to gain more experience and make a little money because it is difficult to work full-time and go through nursing school. There were two hospitals in my small town. I worked at Hospital A in the ICU as a CNA. My clinicals were in the larger hospital. Hospital B. I worked a shift at my hospital and ran over to the other one across town to pick my patient and get my pre-clinical work done. It was about 30 minutes after 7 when I got there. Most hospital shifts you work are 12 hours. 7 to 7. I knew I was going to be on a med-surg floor, so I got on the elevator to ride up and look through my paperwork to find out what unit I'd be at the next day. A lady in a pantsuit with a hospital badge was already on the elevator and gave me a look like I'd peed in her Cheerios. Okay, I just moved to the side and finally found my paper letting me know what floor and unit I needed to go to. In a really ugly tone, the pantsuit asked me, "Where are you headed?" Staying polite, "I'm heading to 3N. She slammed the button and I just said, "Thank you." As we were riding, she turned to me and started chewing me out. "It's not appropriate for you to be coming in 20 minutes after shift change. We've been understaffed all day and those units are slammed right now." I just kinda stared at her for a second and thought, "I'm not going to be disturbing the nurses, and if I have to wait on a chart, that's fine. I don't intend on interrupting report." But I just said, "Okay." If anything, her face got angrier. My floor arrived and she stepped out with me and kept pace with me as I headed to the nurse's station. I went to the side and took a look at the assignment board to see if anyone had a diagnosis I hadn't worked with before. Then sat down out of the way and waited quietly because the charge nurses were still discussing assignments. When they finished, I'd ask the charge nurse if there was a patient I should pick. I'd do this because sometimes there were interesting procedures, or I'd get a chance to practice my skills the next day. As I was waiting, pantsuit lady watched me and when she saw me sit down, she immediately snapped her fingers at me and pointed down to the floor and said, "You come here." The voice was nasty enough that it stopped several people mid-report to find out what was going on. I stood up and approached her and she grabbed my sleeve and pulled me over closer to the charge nurses. Ignoring me and talking directly to the charge nurses, she proceeded to tell them that I was their aide and she wanted them to make sure I was written up for being late. I realized then that she thought I worked there. I was a lot less confrontational or aggressive then. "My, how nursing changes you." But I never really got the chance to say anything as she jerked her hand away from me and wiped it like she just touched poo. Looked at me with a face I can only describe as sour lemon smugness and walked away. The charge looked at me and said, "We already have an aide but sure could use you. Let me see how." She trailed off as I held out my hand and said, "I don't work here. I'm with school name, and I'm here to pick out a patient for clinicals tomorrow." Does that lady always treat people like their dogs? The charge nurse stared at me for a second and then started laughing and said, "Stupid witch. Don't mind her. We all hate her." She then asked, "How much longer do you have?" I replied that I graduate in 6 months. I also asked if they had any interesting procedures, or if they had a patient that a one-to-one student nurse would make easier to handle. She also asked where I planned on working after I graduated. I just looked down the hallway where the pantsuit had gone and just said, "Well, not here." Which made her laugh even more. I had a truly relaxing clinical the next day with a sweet elderly lady with dementia and a minor medical condition. We folded laundry together to keep her busy and to keep her from pulling at her surgical sites. What was really fun about it is that the next semester when representatives come to try to recruit you to the hospital, I got to reply to a question about why I wasn't interested in their hospital. I got to say that I didn't appreciate the way they treated their staff. And tell the story. There was recognition in their eyes when I described the lady, and they shook their heads when I told them about the event. Plus, I knew that my hospital was waiting for me to graduate so I could come to work in the ICU, which was my dream at the time. And it was for a bit more pay than the other hospital was offering anyway. The next one is titled, Karen Attacked a USMC Veteran. I, like so many that have passed through this sub, never fully believed these stories. Seriously, people can't be that dense. Even as a police officer, I cannot recall in my 7 years as a sworn officer coming across some people that are as dense as some of these stories. Well, today disabused me of that notation. Also, this will not be word for word but to the best of my memory. Also, apologizes for my English, I graduated a prestigious private school in the southern US and got my bachelor's in criminology and am working on my master's at a university in the Midwest. So, any mistake in my spelling or grammar is completely my fault. Background: I am a USMC vet and a police officer. Also, I am currently on admin duty because I tore my quad when I failed to properly jump a fence during a foot chase, so I am walking with a cane currently. Cast: Karen equals Karen. AM equals awesome manager. BC equals buddy cop. Me equals hi, it's me. The event: I had just gotten off of my duty shift and decided that since the weather is going to be nice over my weekend, I am going to get a couple steaks, some corn and just stuff for a cookout with a couple of my buddies. I am looking at the steaks, comparing a cut before I put one back. When I hear it, the mating call of the wild Karen, this is a sound that I am familiar with. But she can't seriously think that I work here. I am in a plain, logo-less white polo shirt, tucked into my uniform pants, midnight blue cargo pants, and my black boots. The workers here wear black button-up shirts, khaki pants and a green apron with the store name on it. Managers tend to wear black pants but still have the apron, but with manager on the name tag. Sure enough, it was for me. Since I had ignored her, I earned an even more stern throat clearing directed toward me, and then a shrill, excuse me. I'm a butthole, but I also think I am hilarious. This is a horrible combination when facing a Karen. It is because of this disastrous mix of character traits that I call back to her, without a look, absolutely, you are excused, the bathroom is that way, with a gesture toward the sign for the restrooms, before adding, and I am sure they have something in the pharmacy if you need more than that. Karen. That is no way to speak to a customer, you didn't even ask what I needed. Now, me. Interrupting her, look, I don't care. I am not an employee here, I have no duty to help you. I do not look anything like a staff member here. If there is nothing else, I will be returning to my shopping. Yes, I know, I was rude. I am not going to make excuses for it, I have very little patience for these entitled morons. Karen. In full banshee shriek, I want your manager, I am going to. Me. Going into full knife handing NCO Marine, bellow out, shut your mouth. I am a customer, I don't work here, stop harassing me. The problem with going full devil dog when in public is the general public is not accustomed to the volume level a good yell from the diaphragm can produce. Also, the tone of voice is very hostile. The bigger problem with going full devil dog is when you are using a cane to keep you standing, it becomes very easy for you to be toppled. And this is exactly what Karen did. Fair play, Karen, fair play. She kicked my cane out from under my hand, and I was too far forward to recover and went down like a sack of potatoes. She then started hitting me with her purse. I have been hit harder by pillows wielded by my 6-year-old niece, and yelling about me assaulting her and needing the police. I don't know if it was 2 minutes or 30 seconds, but it wasn't that long. It just felt like it was a bit because I was embarrassed about how easily I went down and how much it hurt my leg. But it was this point that AM comes over and gets Karen off of me and helps me up. The whole time Karen is still screaming until she remembered that she had her own phone and called 911. Screaming things at me like, I'm calling the police, you're in trouble now, and, I didn't ask for you to assault me, what? AM looked at me as confused as I was, and I just shrugged. AM. Do you know what is going on? Me. Yeah, she tried to get my attention, I made a glib remark, she told me to get my manager, I dressed her down, then as I was in the middle of unloading on her, I think she kicked my cane, and I went down. You saw the rest, Karen. Liar. You felt me up and then when I pushed you off of me, you hit me with that stick and if it wasn't for the fact that I hit you with my purse, I'd be dead. At this time, I'm pretty sure the dispatcher had said something to her, as she said into the phone, "Yeah, he is about 6 feet, a large white man, in a white polo and black pants with boots. We're at the less than store name and location greater than. Yes, I think I am safe, the manager is here, but he seems to know my attacker. I think he wants to assault me too. No Karen, no, no one wants to assault you." AM and I exchange looks before AM asks me, "It appears she called the police. Can I ask you the wait in the store?" he says to me. Me. With a nod, "Sure, I'll wait." It was only a couple of minutes before BC comes walking up. Less than my last name greater than. "What is happening here? We got a call about a sexual assault." The fact that I was addressed before Karen sent her into orbit. I could see BC's eye just glaze over, and since I had trained BC when she joined the force, I knew this meant has already tuned the irate Karen out. I just looked at BC and said, "Take her statement. This is the manager on duty, then review the security footage." Karen being Karen starts with the, "We don't need the security footage. This man sexually assaulted me, arrest him." And she also threw this gem out, "You're a woman, and you know him, you must know what type of a man he is. You can be honest that he probably has assaulted you too." BC looked over to the manager and said, "I think it would help more if I were to see that footage first." It was at this point that BC's partner tells the Karen that we both, Karen and I, are supposed to stay with him, while BC goes with the manager. Apparently, not only did the security camera catch everything in 1080p, but it also had audio. BC returned about 5 minutes later, looked at her partner and then pointed to Karen. "Arrest her for assault and making a false report." BC then got into Karen's face and said, "I have been assaulted in the past. It is people like you that make false claims that make it so hard for us actual victims to get the help we need." And that was really the end of it. The AM helped me get the rest of my things for the grill out, and I got a nice 25% off coupon. The next one is titled, "I became a ninja to hide from a scary woman." So, a few weeks ago I was shopping in a store called Uniqlo. It's a Japanese retail store that sells good quality clothing for a decent and sometimes pricey prices. So, in my country a lot of the Uniqlo employees are Eastern Asian, so as an Eastern Asian person I sometimes get mistaken for an employee, which can be solved with a simple, "I don't work here." Which can be understood, and they would leave me alone. But this special little lady whom I'll name Karen is this short, cute lady who doesn't look like a Karen. In fact she was really attractive, green eyes, brunette, curly hair, black and short. So, I was a bit awestruck when I saw her, until she opened her mouth. "Karen. Where are the coats? Op. Sorry, what? Karen. Little louder. Where are the coats? Op. Oh, I don't work here. Karen. Sure, you don't just hurry up and take me to the coats, I'm in a rush." Now I wasn't sure what to do for a moment. I could tell she was someone who will not listen to a word I say, so I quickly thought of something on the spot and pointed at a random aisle. "Op. It's right this way." She looks at where I'm pointing and I legged the hell out of there. Obviously I didn't run since I would get in trouble, so I quickly walked instead, and I have long legs. As I was walking I pulled out my backpack, pulled out my long trench coat, I slipped it on and faced a random wall. I thought to myself and begging to some sort of higher up to help me hide from this Karen. I tried to erase my existence and just blend with the wall. I am one with the wall is me. Behind me I hear the stomping of what I presume is the Karen and I felt a gush of wind pass me. I was shocked, she actually didn't notice me. Before she left the aisle I can hear her capturing a poor actual employee. "Karen. Excuse me, one of your co-workers was incredibly rude to me and ditched me after I asked for help." "Employee. Oh, I do apologize for that, may I ask who it is?" "Karen. It was this tall, fat, nerdy looking girl." "Employee. Sorry but you're going to need to be more specific." She kept describing me to the employee, but they were confused, they ended up going to the front desk. I couldn't believe that I actually managed to get away with that. Once the coast was clear I left to go buy the anime shirts they had, and I managed to find a Naruto shirt which I took to the self-checkout. When I got there I noticed Karen was still here, but she was quite far from me, and she was talking to a different employee who I presume is the manager. I could tell from their expressions that they're still trying to figure the rude employee. But all in all, I found out I could become a ninja and I am great at hiding. Legend has it that she's still trying to find the rude employee. This is the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed the stories. Please don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like the video and write a comment. I really appreciate your support and it helps my channel so much. Thank you.